Let's go ahead and introduce forms in a very basic state by rigging one up for our Redis FlushDB button. Up till now, that button doesn't really do much. So we can click on it and it's just not gonna do anything. We went to a hash, but that's about it. So we can get rid of that. And let's go ahead and hide our browser back away and let's dive back into our homepage. I'm gonna go ahead and close out some of these files that we're not using anymore. And let's scroll down to that button. So currently we have it as a button. It's an href just going to a hash as we saw within the browser whenever we clicked it. In the most basic state for forms, we're gonna want to wrap the button in a form just like so, and we can indent this. We rigged our button component up to where whenever we pass it as an href, it will be applied as an anchor. And anytime href is not added, it will be rendered as a button. So what we can do is just get rid of the href, and now our button's a button, and we can specify the type as submit so that now whenever we click our button, that will automatically submit our form. If we give this a save, jump back into our browser, we can verify that because the behavior is now going to change. If we give this button a click, our page will do a refresh. As you can see, our images is re-rendered, and now we're at a question mark page. Let's get rid of that real quick. Okay, cool. Let's hide this back once more. What we need is for a URL for our form to act against, to perform some action for the form's posting. So for that, we can define an action. This action is going to need a URL that we have defined within a route. If we dive into our routes, I'm going to hold Command or Control P to open up our file explorer. We can dive into our routes file, and right down here we have our router.delete, and we particularly want to use our flush method. So that's redis.flush. So let's dive back into our homepage and let's add in an action for route redis.flush, just like so. One last thing that we need to do though is specify a method. For HTML forms, this method is going to be post. By default, HTML forms aren't going to support delete, put, patch, like we have the ability to define within our routes. So we have this route defined as a delete, but we need it to be a post in order for our HTML form to actually be able to use this. So we'll see in the next lesson how we can keep this as delete, but for right now, let's switch this to post so that we can move onward. Let's dive back into our homepage and let's give everything a save. Let's dive back into our browser. Let's open up our inspector and let's dive into the network tab. Let's switch our network tab over to all. And then we're also going to want to go into the gear icon and persist our logs. Whenever we click the flush Redis DB button, our page will do a refresh and our log will clear out by default. But with that persist logs on, we'll still be able to see and inspect our network requests as we refresh our page. Cool. So now we can go ahead and click our flush Redis DB button. And just like so, we see a bunch of requests go out. But if we scroll up to the top, we should see the initial request that went out that caused all of these subsequent requests from our page refreshing. And that's a post request to our flush method. If we dive into that, we can see that we got back a 302 found. Within the response headers, we can scroll down a little bit further and we can see that it sent back a redirect location to slash. So our homepage, essentially redirecting us back to where we were. If we take a look at the request, we didn't send any information. If we take a look at the response, it's our page. Cool. So we can hide that away. Looking at our network request, everything appears to have worked properly. But if we dive into our terminal, we're going to see an invalid or expired CSRF token warning for this particular request. Furthermore, if we dive back into our text editor, let's scroll up to our controllers and let's go into our Redis controller, particularly within our flush method, as this is the method that we're calling with our form. If we add a console.log flushing Redis database here, we'll give that a save. Let's jump back into our browser and let's click our button once more. We see the exact same behavior, everything refreshed. If we scroll down, we'll see another flush request go out right about here. And if we dive back into our terminal, we're going to see that invalid or expired CSRF token warning again, but we're also not going to see that console log that we had. So we're never actually reaching our flush route handler right here, and our cache is never actually getting flush because of that CSRF warning. CSRF stands for Cross-Site Request Forgery, and it's a protection system provided by AdonisJS Shield to prevent unauthorized submissions of forms on behalf of authenticated users within our application. Whenever you're working with session-based applications, CSRF protection is a must-have to help protect your users and your application from unauthorized access to that authenticated user session, so that the forms cannot be submitted on that user's behalf by something else. And if we dive into our config shield file, we'll see a CSRF section within here. And by default, whenever we create a new web starter kit application, this is going to be enabled. And this will apply for methods that can post information to our application, like post, put, patch, and delete. So everything is actually working exactly as we expected. There's just one thing that we need to do to actually make this work within our application. So if we dive back into our homepage, back into our form, all that we need to do is specify a CSRF token within our form, and AdonisJS will both set and check that token for us to verify that it is an authorized action being performed. We can easily provide in a CSRF token within our form by doing double curly braces and calling the CSRF field function, just like so. This will automatically apply in an input that's hidden within our form with a CSRF token as its value. So we can give this a save. Let's jump back into our browser and let's inspect our page. So we can dive into our div, we can dive into our fixed element, and dive into our form. And sure enough, there is that hidden input called underscore CSRF with our CSRF token value within it. Let's dive back into our network tab and let's clear our current log out so that it's a little bit easier to work with. And let's attempt to flush our Redis DB one more time. Okay, we saw everything go out. It behaved the exact same as it did before. If we inspect this request and take a look at the request data, we're now going to see a CSRF token being sent up with the form data so that AdonisJS can check it and verify it's valid. And furthermore, if we inspect our terminal, we're going to see that that CSRF token warning is no longer there, and we indeed did flush our Redis database. Cool. So everything's now working exactly as we expected now that we're providing in that CSRF token with our form submission.